Hi, kindergarten. It's Mrs. Betts again. I have another story for you this week. The story is called Mrs. McTats and Her House Full of Cats. It's written by Alyssa Satin Cappicelli. The pictures are by Joan Rankin. So let's get started. As I'm reading the story, I want you to notice the names of the cats and see if you notice anything in particular about them. There's something special about them. Here we go. In a small cozy cottage lived Mrs. McTats. She lived all alone except for one cat. Every morning she left as the clock struck 8, to market, I mustn't be late. She browsed through the market and chose a plump fish for Abner and me. What a sumptuous dish. But when she got home, there came a scratch at the door and in walked 2 cats. Was there room for 2 more? "Come in, my sweet dears," said Mrs. McTats. "I'm sure I've got room for just 2 more cats. I'll call you Basil, and Curly you'll be. I only had 1 cat, but now I have 3. The very next morning, Mrs. McTats woke early. She stopped to pet Abner and Basil and Curly. To market, I mustn't be late. This chicken, I think, will surely taste great. But when she got home, there came a scratch at the door, and in walked 3 cats. Was there room for 3 more? "Come in, my sweet dear," said Mrs. McTats. "I think I've got room for just 3 more cats. Now give me a moment, what shall your names be? Your Dolly, your Ernest, and Fuzzy makes 3. The very next morning, off went Mrs. McTats. "What can I buy for my 6 hungry cats?" "I've got it," she said, "I'll make a nice stew." So she carried home beef and liver to brew. But back at home, there came a scratch at the door, and in walked 4 cats. Was there room for 4 more? "Come in, my sweet dears," said Mrs. McTats. "I know there's a place for just 4 more cats. 10's a fine number, 10 cats and me. I'll call you Goldie, and Herman you'll be." Izzy and Jezebel pranced across the floor, and then right behind them followed 5 more. Coco and Linus, Millie, Noreen, and you shall be Oscar. There, that makes 15. The very next day, off went Mrs. McTats. "What can I possibly feed 15 cats?" She chose a fresh tuna. She chose a fresh trout. But when she got home, her cats were all out. She counted her cats from 1 to 15, but somehow 6 more cats had just joined the scene. "Come, come, my sweet dears," said Mrs. McTats. "I'm sure I have plenty for 21 cats. Pip, Quip, and Rosebud. Sally and Tozy, Ursula dear, do make yourself cozy." But then came another scratch on the door. Could it be more cats? How many more? In came Violet, in came Winnie, and just behind, a kitten she named Zinny. In came Yodel, the last of the bunch. 25 cats ready for lunch. But something was missing. What could it be? Just what it was, Mrs. McTats could not see. As she stood there puzzling, there was a scratch on the door, and Mrs. McTats wondered, could there really be more? Could she squeeze in more cats, more than 25? Who was the one who was next to arrive? Come in, my sweet dear, said Mrs. McTats. I live in this cottage with 25 cats. But if you don't mind, you're welcome to stay. You're welcome to eat. You're welcome to play. What do you think it's gonna be? Now in that small cottage lives Mrs. McTats, all happy and cozy with her 25 cats. And one little puppy who's known as Zoom in a small cozy cottage with plenty of room. Did you figure out what the special thing is about all the animals' names, all the cats' names, and the puppy? It ends, Zoom ends with, or begins with a Z. And remember at the very beginning, the first cat she had, the name of that cat was, let's see if you remember what it was. Abner, eh? As she kept getting cats, she went through the alphabet and named her cats. Abner, Basil, B, Curly, C. And we're gonna keep going. Dolly, D, Ernest, E, Fuzzy, F, all the way to Zoom. So, our last page. And just when the clock strikes each morning at 8, Mrs. McTats hurries off. I mustn't be late. To market, what treats will there be for 26 deers from A to Z? And that's our story of Mrs. McTats and her house full of cats. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next week.